Notice says, is there a guide for interpreting Blue Jay arming beeps? What's there to interpret, Notice? It goes doot-doot-doot, doot-doot. There you go.
I helped Notice with an issue, with this issue.
Yeah, tell me.
For people who don't know, some of the ESC firmwares have a what Crom in your Discord, one of the know-it-alls in your Discord, refers to as a negative beep, which is a term I use now. Okay. Which is that if it does not see a signal, it actually goes doo-doo.
I've noticed doo-doo. That. Yeah, AM32 does that.
AM32 will also sit there and continually beep if it's missing the signal from the FC. So before, all our signal, it was just three beeps or the music. And then if you don't hear the other two, you know, okay, it didn't see the FC. But now we have like sort of a...
Which is a problem. Because what would happen is you'd have three ESCs go doot-doot, doot-doot, and the fourth one would go doot-doot, and then not be working. But you wouldn't know. And then you try to take off and it would go... Vroom. Whereas now it goes doo 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 doo, except one of them is going doo 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 doo, and you're like, oh shit, I have a problem. It annoyed me at first because my quad was just sitting there beeping for 20 minutes, you know, while I was working on the flight controller. But then I was like, no, actually, this is a good idea.
Yeah. So if you're aware of that, as far as I know, though. Like for instance, AM32, I think, only has, like, four different kind of things it can do, and two of them are, like, errors. One is the normal, and then one of them is that, like, the constant beeping to let you know you're not connected. So I don't think there's really a guide. I think it's just, like, knowing about that negative beep and what it means.
Yeah. Yeah. The only other thing that ESCs usually can do is, if you're using a PWM signal, not D-shot, then you do calibration. And the way calibration works is you'll power the ESC down, you'll raise the motor slider all the way up so that it's getting a full PWM signal, and then you'll plug in the power and it'll go do 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 is the usual BL Heli way of doing it. And that indicates that it's detected that you want to calibrate and it's read the full throttle position. And then you'll move the sliders all the way down. It'll go do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And that means that it's detected the zero throttle position. And then it'll go do-do. And that's the calibration sequence. And most people won't encounter that because they're not using PWM. But sometimes you'll get a flight controller in a weird state where it's outputting a PWM signal. And when you plug in, it'll do the calibration tones. Way back when, there used to be a thing you would do where you would leave the throttle high and you would enter a menu and the ESC would beep a pattern at you, doot doot, and then you would go down up and it would go doot doot doot, and you had a table you were looking at that told you which options you were changing, and that was so fun. That was so fun. You would buy a programming card, which was a special little electronic device that you plugged into these ESCs that would let you change the options without having to do the throttle bullshit.